These kids are runaways, most of them. They got drug addictions, medical issues.
And they need our help.
Yeah, but Chuck, I mean, they need to go home. They're making our congregation uncomfortable.
Well, maybe they should be uncomfortable. Maybe we all should. Maybe it's my job to make us uncomfortable. And I haven't been doing it.
Chuck, stop. This is enough. This is a house of worship, and yes, we expect a certain level of dignity here. These girls are wearing halter tops, and half of them aren't even wearing shoes.
They're staining the new shag carpet with their bare feet.
A carpet? Yeah. Oh, yeah, let's be sure to save the carpet.
You keep this up, and you're going to drive away the only contributing members that we've got. You hearing me now?
Loud and clear.
What is going on?
Place that right over there on that towel. And this other one here. There we go. Yeah. Baptize these feet in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. There you go.
Welcome to church.
Hello, you. Let's have that foot, please. This is terrific. Okay. Place them both on that towel, and then step on into church. Welcome.
Thank you.
Hello, young lady. How are you? Let's have that foot. Let's have that other foot.
Yeah, why don't you go sit next to that fella in the cantaloupe jacket? Good to see you.
Thank you.
Enjoy. Welcome to church. Hello, young lady.
Well, last year I had the privilege of visiting New York City. I'm not getting a tourist. I paid a visit to the Statue of Liberty, and I read those famous words. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses, yearning to breathe free. And as I read those words, I thought, well, that's Christianity, isn't it? It's the essence of it. An invitation to the broken. Jesus was very friendly with the outcasts. In Revelation 22, it says, let the one who can hear say, come. Let the one who is thirsty, come. Let the one who desires take the waters of life freely.